So I am in Adelaide. I'm just looking at myself on the camera here. I don't think I look too good. Had a number of beers last night watching my team lose the football. But what I want to do in this video is manage to get my hands on a Cervelo S5. Rod Anderson from Pond, Australia, they're the distributor of Cervelo. Handed the bike to me on Friday and I've got it for 3 days. Now there'll be a full review coming on this bike shortly on the channel, but if you've been supporting this channel for a while, you'll know that I like to do a first impressions, just give you my raw thoughts, which is what I'm going to do in this video. So let's go numbers, speed and stiffness, and comfort. So starting with numbers, I weighed this bike at Pond Australia when I picked it up, and it was about 7.8 kilograms. Now, this is a 54 centimeter. If I compare that to a Venge 54 centimeter, it's got about 400 grams heavier than the Venge. Now the grip sets are different. You've got Shimano DR2 on the Venge versus Sram eTap on this bike here. And the wheels, you've got DT Swiss 45s on here. You've got deeper profiles on the Venge. So it's a heavier proposition. And I think I understand why, which I'll explain shortly. You can get 28 mil tires in this bike here. Currently got 23s, not sure why, I'd probably prefer a 25 at least on an aero road bike. And lastly, if we're talking about numbers, clearly stiffness has been a focus on this new Cervelo S5 in comparison to its predecessor. And the front end, obviously the handlebar system, which is very interesting, they say it's about 13% stiffer. And the back end, if you look how chunky the bottom bracket is, or the bottom bracket area is down there, we're talking about 25% more stiffness. Okay, speed and stiffness. Now, I need to start with stiffness because, fuck me, this is a very stiff bike. I would have to say, possibly the stiffest aero road bike I've ever ridden. Which is interesting because if you watched my previous review on the Venge versus the Chapter 2 Rare, I talk about camtail versus airfoil design and really camtail having more benefits surrounding creating a stiffer road bike. But this is an airfoil design and this might be the stiffest aero road bike I've ever ridden. So you got to kind of question how have Cervelo done that? And you just got to look down at the thing and there's a lot going on there. When I say a lot going on, like some of the tube shapes are very, very thick, robust, particularly around the bottom bracket area. You've got this handlebar system, the fishbone, two-piece system, fully integrated, that creates more stiffness as well. So just to wrap up on stiffness, you know, I mentioned earlier this bike was a little heavier than the Specialized Venge, and I think what Cervelo have done is to meet KPIs surrounding stiffness, there's just more on this frame in certain areas, which if your KPI is to make a super stiff aero road bike, makes a lot of sense. Now in terms of speed, like what I notice on this bike most of all is when I'm up to say 35 kilometers or a touch more, I'm in a little bit of a headwind now, but you stop pedaling and the ability for the bike to maintain speed is seriously next level. And I look at the front end of this bike, you know, the head tube, airfoil design, the fishbone handlebar system, and it makes a lot of sense that this bike doesn't really block the wind at the front, which a lot of bikes do. So the ability to maintain speed, and also the way it darted down Mount Lofty yesterday, the way it generated speed, once again, Cervelo have done an excellent job with making this bike not only stiff, but super fast. So I'm in the city of Adelaide, just got back from my second ride on the Cervelo S5. Quickly on handling before we talk about comfort, these bikes all handle so well, so it's very hard for me to give meat on the bone when I'm talking about cornering out of the saddle because they're all elite. In regards to comfort, now to be fair to the Cervelo S5, there's some 23 mil tires on this bike, which isn't ideal, I think, for an aero road bike. You want at least 25s. I'd have 25s, PSI about 85 to 95, and I think it would make the bike a little bit more comfortable than what I've experienced. Now, that's not to say it's not an uncomfortable road bike. The way this bike manages the road buzz and vibration, I think it does a really good job. you look at the seat stays, the handlebar system, it's taking pressure out of the lower back and the neck and shoulders. However, I was just on Anzac Highway here in Adelaide. If you've been here for the tour down under, you'll probably know there's a lot of road bumps and divots. And at times, I felt like I was riding a raging bull, the way this managed the bumps and divots. And I think that's to be expected. You can't have one of the stiffest aerodynamic road bikes in the world and also have something that's comfortable at the same time. I'm not saying it's not comfortable. You can definitely take it on 150, 200 kilometer rides, but expect something that's fast, aerodynamic, and super stiff. If you're keen to see the full review on where I'm going to drill more into, say, the handlebar system and the technicalities of the bike, make sure you subscribe below, and I hope to catch you in my next video.